basic anatomy, and then I'll take some topics or the other. Now let's say what we have, the respiratory system. Respiratory system is all related to your trachea, bronchi, as well as tracheobronchial tree, right? So let's say this is what the trachea. Now, what is the trachea made up of? Because in medicine, remember that we also have a little bit about anatomy, physiology, pathology, and pharmacology, whatever we have learned in the previous years, all will be collected together. Yes. Remember that medicine is all subject together. So when we are teaching through medicine, always we start with anatomical concepts, then we go to the physiological concepts, and then we start some disease. Then it is understood properly. Yes. If you are starting directly from the topics, then it is difficult to understand. Like for example, this is what the Davidson respiratory system. So initial few topics. Now, before we understand go into any disease, let's first understand the anatomical concept. Of course, this is a trachea. This is what is an left bronchus and the right bronchus, right?
Yes.
And we all know left bronchus, if you can see properly, left bronchus is a little smaller than the right bronchus. Yes. The reason behind this is?
The heart is...
Left lung has got two lobes. Right lung has got three lobes. Also, left lung is a little lesser in volume than that because of the presence of the heart, right? So it again divides into other two, three branches, second and third generation. And then we have something called the bronchopulmonary segments, if you remember, which I've done that in the physiology as well as in anatomy. Function of this tracheobronchial tree, does it help in oxygen and carbon dioxide exchange? The tracheobronchial tree I'm talking about, whatever things are being shown in the picture, does it help in oxygen carbon dioxide exchange? It doesn't take part because it has got only it is made up of what?
Cartilage,
smooth muscles, as well as the mucus glands. What does the mucus gland do?
Protect the airway.
Mucus gland protect the airway by trapping the impurities which are there in the air.
Yes.
Trapping the impurities which are there in the air. So it doesn't help in oxygen and carbon. Function of it is only to trap the impurities. It is to humidify the air. It adds water content in the air. And also it adjusts the temperature of the air.
Yes.
So that by the time it goes into the alveoli, this word, for example, an alveolus, this is what an artery. Alveolus and arteriole. By the time it reaches to alveoli, the temperature, moisture, as well as the impurities. Impurities are reduced, temperature, moisture is adjusted so that it can move down into a proper oxygen carbon dioxide exchange. That is what can be possible. Of course, these are the bronchopulmonary segments we know of. Let's go now. This is what is an alveolus. These are the alveoli, and we have a capillaries which are surrounding it.
Yes.
Right? These are the capillaries. Now, it is this that helps into oxygen and carbon dioxide exchange. Oxygen as well as carbon dioxide exchange. So, something that was important. Now, this is what the normal X-ray. Again, X-ray normal will be coming up. Because most of the pulmonary pathologies, the first thing what is important in the pulmonary pathologies is to understand, is to go for an X-ray. Because all the pulmonary pathologies, first investigation of choice is always an X-ray chest. So when we take the proper lecture, we first explain the normal X-ray pattern. How this is what is in trachea. Now in X-ray, remember that it is always black and white, right?
Yes.
So, what looks black? What looks white?
White is the soft tissue.
White is the soft tissue, right? White is the soft tissue, and what is black is all air, right?
Air, yes.
It's all air. So, let's start from the trachea. Trachea looks central in this particular case. This is the right border of the heart. This is the left border of the heart. This is the right hemidiaphragm. This is the left hemidiaphragm.
Yes.
Then we have, these are the ribs. These are the ribs on the other side. Now, this is the, like you can see, these are the apex of the lungs. Lungs are divided into three zones, right? For the anatomic as well as physiological concept. We have upper zones, middle zones, and the lower zones.
Yes.
And the lower zones. Now, we also have something that is important, because when we learn about the X-rays, this is what is an angle. This is what is also an angle.
Yes.
These are the angles. What is it called as? this angle called as what?
Costophrenic angles.
Yes, these are costophrenic angles. This is important to be very much pointed because it gives an idea about fluid collection. Like condition called as pleural effusions. Condition called as pleural effusion. If you can also see the right hemidiaphragm is slightly elevated than the left hemidiaphragm. Let me draw with the blue color.
Yes.
Reason behind this is a liver which is located here.
Yeah, yes.
The liver. This is what the normal called as fundus or stomach bubble. Stomach bubble. At this particular thing, you see some white shadows. Those are the white shadows of the hilum of the lung. Where we have the bronchus, where we have an artery, bronchial artery, pulmonary artery, some lymph nodes that can show these white shadows. Normal texture of the lung, if you can see, is in grayish black.
Yes.
Grayish black. That is what the normal structure. If it looks white, then also can be a problem. If it looks black, that can also be a problem. But we relate that with what looks white and what looks black. Then we can understand what exactly can be the problem in the lungs. So let's go to some pathology so that we can understand. Let's go to some pathology. What are the pulmonary function tests you remember of? Pulmonary function test. It was there in physiology. This is something. Because again, before we go to any pathology, you need to understand about investigations of the lungs. You can see we have something called a tidal volume. What is that?
Yes. Lung tidal volume is...
It's a normal amount of air that you are inhaling and exhaling.
Yes.
In a resting condition, that is about 500 ml.
Yes.
We also have something called an inspiratory reserve volume.
Yes.
That is what? If you can see, let me zoom it so that you can understand. Let me zoom it. Okay. Can you see the picture now?
Yes.
So, in the investigation of the lungs, this is what is a tidal volume.
Okay.
That means the resting condition is about 500 ml. About 500.
Yes.
So, over now, this is what is the tidal inhalation and tidal exhalation. Tidal inhalation and tidal exhalation. Can you see? Can you see the small prints I'm doing there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You can. If the things are not visible, you can also zoom at your level. Huh? Even if I am not zooming, you can also zoom at your level.
Okay.
Can you do that? You can also zoom. And another advantage of this an interactive online class is you can also write on the board. Can you? There's a pen icon just above the audio icon. Small annotation. Yes. You can also click on that and you can also write on the board. Can you do that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I think you are using a yellow pen, right?
Yes, sir. Okay.
You can also choose colors and you can also write on the board. Then because of that, it rather becomes more interactive than any other sessions.
Yes.
Because there is no classroom in which the students will write on the board. For example, if I want to point out, ye dikhao, wo dikhao, you can also point out. That is what becomes, it becomes in a more interactive sessions. So, I was talking about, this is what the tidal volume. Now, over and above tidal inhalation, you can also inhale little bit air. This is what is an extra, right?
Yes.
See, upstroke is inhalation. Downstroke is exhalation. So, over and above normal tidal inhalation, this is what is an inspiratory reserve volume.
Yes.
That means over and above tidal inhalation, you can also inhale some air more in. That is what is called as tidal inhalation. Oh, sorry, inspiratory reserve volume. Inspiratory reserve volume. We also have an expiratory reserve volume. Logic says, this is what the normal exhalation. Beyond that, you are also able to exhale some air out. That is what is called as an expiratory reserve volume. All these volumes and capacities very commonly asked in the VIVAs because those will be important for COPD, those will be important for an asthma, those will be important for any lung or including the CRPDs also because I think for occupational therapy, more important thing would be occupational lung disorders.
Yes.
Yeah, what are those disorders, occupational lung disorders?
Asbestosis.
Yes. What happens? What exactly happens in that?
When the asbestos gets deposited in the lungs,
And that causes what?
It causes cough.
It causes fibrosis. The most important thing is in fibrosis.
Fibrosis. Yes, fibrosis.
Go to some important basic topics so that we can understand. Okay, I'm just flipping the chronic obstructive pulmonary disorders. Now, advantage of going through the book is we are very sure that we're not skipping anything or you're not missing anything.
Mm-hmm.
Because a lot of my students are today's age and opting for directly taking from the book so that they can understand what exactly we are supposed to read from the book and what are we not supposed to read. We also understand that what an MCQs can come up. So medicine we are teaching through Davidson. Surgery we are teaching through Manipal.
Okay.
Obstetric and gynec are teaching through standard like in Datta because everyone refers that only. And pediatric through OP guy. Through OP guy. That is how the things are. Now of course whenever you are answering any question of medicine, there is a specific format in which we need to answer. Now let me give you the format before we go to any topic. So this is what I am using as a whiteboard. Okay. The first thing what we need to do for any medicine topic is give an etiology.
Yes.
What do you mean by etiology?
The cause of the disease.
Yes, it is an etiology. First thing is an etiology. Second thing what we have is a pathogenesis.
Okay.
Is a pathogenesis. Now third thing is the clinical features. In that we have signs as well as symptoms. Remember that for answering any LAQ in medicine or even if it is surgery or any other topic, we have to have been going through this particular format. First was etiology. What is etiology means?
Cause of the disease.
The causes. And also etiology means also risk factors.
Okay.
Because for example, we're talking about an ischemic heart disease. The risk factors are similar to etiology. Like for example, diabetes mellitus and hypertension and cholesterol. Those become the risk factors.
Yes.
So explain those risk factors that which cause, what is an exactly relationship between the risk factor and the disease. Second point was pathogenesis. What exactly is pathogenesis?
How the disease progresses.
How the disease will progress, how the disease will occur. So it gives an idea about how normal anatomy will become an abnormal anatomy. The patho is what? Abnormality. Genesis is what? Formation. Then we go to the clinical features. Clinical features may have signs as well as symptoms. Fourth important thing will be investigations to diagnose it.
Yes.
Fifth point will be complications of the disease. Sixth point will be management. The management, of course, is a medicine class, so we write more of the medical management. And also a word about surgical management, because a lot of disorders in which we also have a surgical treatment of the disease. So this is how the format. Even if it is an SAQ, or even if it is an LAQ, we write in the same format.
Okay.
Only thing is in SAQ, you would write very in short, but in LAQ, we write in a length. We describe. That is how. So this format need to be there for all the disorders. Now let's go to the asthma. Because this can be asked as an important LAQ, long answer question. Yeah. Now let me give an overview. What are we going to learn? Now remember that in 5 minutes I'm going to discuss the whole asthma. In short, that we can have an idea about what exactly we are going to learn. And then we're going to take things forward. Now, remember that asthma, first of all, is an allergic disorder.
Yes.
That is what happens in the asthma. We have certain allergens. When the patient inhales those allergens, patient produces the allergic response, patient produces bronchoconstriction, and patient produces inflammation. There are three things in it. What are those three things?
Allergic response, bronchoconstriction.
And inflammatory response. When we go to the etiology of this, allergies, there are two types of an allergies, or there are two types of an asthmas, what we can know. One is an intrinsic asthma, another is an extrinsic asthma.
Okay.
Now, usually whenever we start any topic, I'll just give an overview of the topic before we start into, and then we'll go to the what are all details we're going to learn.
Okay.
Because of the overview, we need to know this is what the stem of the topic. To understand a tree, it is important to understand the stem first. Because whenever you are drawing a tree, we always draw the stem first, then draw the branches, and then draw the flowers, right?
Yes.
Similarly, to understand a topic, you need to understand the stem first, then branches, and then flowers and petals. That is always an idea. So, sorry. Let me erase this. One second. So that I can, let me erase, I'm erasing this. Let's erase completely. Take care. So first point, what I talked about is an allergic response. What are the two types of allergic responses? Intrinsic asthma and
extrinsic.
What do you mean by intrinsic and extrinsic? Intrinsic intrinsic ka matlab is the cause of an allergy is inherent into the body of himself, body of the patient. That means it has got nothing to do with the allergens outside. It has something to do from inside, from intrinsic asthma. What is extrinsic asthma? This is also called an atopic asthma.
Okay.
Atopic means? Atopic is what? Atopic means the allergy. That means it has got something to do with outside allergens. Now, logically, if the patient has got atopic asthma, the asthmatic attacks will be more common during the particular season, right? Because in particular season, we have got most common cause of an allergens is the pollen grains.
Yes.
The pollen grains are there during a specific season. So this type of an asthma, extrinsic type, is also called as a seasonal asthma.
Okay.
Also called as a seasonal. Also called, so there are three names of the same thing. Seasonal asthma, extrinsic asthma, and atopic asthma. And atopic asthma. And in intrinsic asthma is also called as a non-seasonal asthma. Is also called as a non-atopic asthma. Because there is nothing to do with an allergic response to any pollen grains. Or this is also called as a genetic asthma. Genetic. This runs in the families. Of course, both of them run in the families. So that was an etiology as well as the pathogenesis. Pathogenesis, there are three things. What are those? Allergic response, bronchoconstriction.
Bronchoconstriction and inflammation.
And inflammatory response. So if you go to these three things, what are the symptoms? Clinical features. Third point was the clinical features, right? What are the clinical features? Logically, if the patient is exposed to the allergen, the first thing is the allergic response. So you can have running nose. I can also have something called rhinorrhea, or I can also have the bronchoconstriction. So what will happen if the bronchi getting constricted? Bronchi getting constricted. So there will be
difficulty in breathing.
Breathlessness. Now breathlessness, right? Now these symptoms will come acutely, or these symptoms will be gradually building up?
They will come acutely.
Acutely, because patient is exposed to an allergens. So they will come. So, so this patient is going to have an acute attack or acute presentation of maybe allergic response and breathlessness. Also, they can be cough along with, because breathlessness goes because of bronchoconstriction. He is trying to throw that mucus out. Mucus, here we have the mucus production is an allergic mucus. Remember that. Here the mucus that is producing allergic mucus. So in the clinical features, we discuss these three things, three clinical features. Rhinorrhea, or maybe running nose, or maybe an allergic response, bronchoconstriction, and the breathlessness also is a cough. Will the patient produce sputum? Sputum will be produced. So when we say cough, will it be a productive cough or non-productive cough?
It will be productive.
Productive cough is more common in the COPDs. Remember that, because there the dust particles or the pollution is producing more mucus. In this case, it's an allergic response. So cough, sputum is very less. So I can say it is a more or less dry cough to a small amount of sticky sputum that come out. Now, in case of an COPD, because COPD patient is exposed to that dust particles more and more, because COPD is, for example, chronic smoking is one of the most common cause of COPD.
Yes.
So smoke particle will produce more mucus. It is a smoke particle that is going inside, produces more mucus, and then more mucus is thrown out. So COPD type is an irritative response, irritation to the tracheobronchial. This is an allergic response. So amount of sputum produced in COPD will be much more compared to that in asthma. So that is what we're going to describe. Fourth important point was, what are your findings? That means signs. What will be your findings? Patient will be having breathing difficulty, right?
Yes.
Will it be an inhalation problem or exhalation problem?
Exhalation.
Why not inhalation?
I think
more problem will be during inhalation or exhalation.
Inhalation, yes.
Just understand, this is what is the bronchus. When the air goes into the bronchus, what is the normal response of the bronchi when the air goes in?
They will
dilate, expand. Right?
Yes.
They will expand. So, they will expand. So, let's say this patient has got bronchoconstriction. So, at least during inhalation, it will dilate a little bit because normal response is dilatation.
Yes.
So, if the bronchi are constricted and the air is going in, bronchi will dilate a little bit. So that at least inhalation mein problem itna jyada nahi hoga because it are dilating. But during exhalation, they will come to the bronchoconstricted position and they'll again constrict more because exhalation mein normal response is exhalation. So this patient has got more difficulty in exhalation than inhalation.
Okay.
Right? So what are your findings? What are your signs? First of all, this patient will be using more of the having difficulty in exhalation. So this patient will be using an accessory muscles of exhalation. Which are the accessory muscles of exhalation?
Accessory muscles.
Are abdominal muscles.
Yes, abdominal.
Yeah, when you contract the abdominal muscles, you are able to exhale more forcibly. When you are coughing, what are you doing? It's a forceful exhalation, right? You are using the abdominal muscles.
Yes.
You see the LA nasi, nostrils will dilate as well as abdominal muscle will be used. What happens to the respiratory rate? That is also part of your findings. Respiratory rate will be more or less?
More.
It will be more because what happens to the tidal volume?
Tidal volume will decrease.
Will decrease because that the respiratory rate is increased, right?
Yes.
Tidal volume will increase. Will you, in your findings, you may also see a cyanosis if the patient is having acute bronchoconstriction. Or very severe bronchoconstriction, maybe cyanosis will be there. That is what will be your findings. Or in your, when you are exam, in your signs, first of all, you have seen that the LA nasi used, abdominal muscles are used, cyanosis may be there. Then what we do, you do the local examination or maybe an examination because in the signs, you also examine the patient. Remember that whenever we are examining the patient, we have four things. Inspection, palpation,
yes.
Percussion and auscultation.
Auscultation.
So in this particular point, we need to know about what are your inspection findings, palpation findings, percussion findings, and auscultation findings. Inspection findings you have already mentioned. Konsa devo? Inspection findings were LA nasi are used, abdominal muscles are used, and cyanosis. That is what we see, right?
Okay. Yes.
In palpation, what we do? Even that respiratory system examination, we have that. Tactile vocal parameters, chest expansion, right? What will happen to the chest expansion? Will the chest move properly, bilaterally equal or unequal?
It will move equally, but lesser than
usual. That is. Also, in the inspection, the size of the lungs will be more or less. What happened to the size of the lungs?
Size.
There's something called them. Have you heard of the barrel chest?
Yes, yes.
Why would there be a barrel chest? Everything has got a logic behind this. So, air is going in the lungs, but air is not coming out.
Yes.
Right? So, what will happen to the amount of air in the lungs?
It's increased, yes.
Increased. So, the chest will be expanded like a barrel chest.
Yes.
That is also your palpation finding. Of course, inspection finding also. So, but the lung expansion will be equal on both sides, but the fingers are moving less. Oh, percussion, may we won't find anything. Auscultation, what will we find? Auscultation.
Wheezing, typical wheezing on exhalation.
The wheezing on inhalation sound or exhalation sounds?
On exhalation.
The exhalation sound, because there's more problem during exhalation. See, when you understand the topic well, it is easy to also answer or relate the other things. This was my fourth point. Fifth point is what? Investigation. What investigation you will ask for? That also we have found out in the clinical examination. First of all, what will we do? I'm going to go for a chest x-ray. Yes. What do you find in the chest x-ray?
Chest.
What will you find in the chest X-ray? Relate those things, what we have learned right now.
More, there will be more air
going in. So lungs will be what? Hyperinflated lungs.
Yes.
That means, how will you, what are the X-ray findings in hyperinflated lungs?
Hyperinflated.
Lung volume will be larger.
Yes.
Right? So heart will look smaller. That is what is something called a teardrop heart. Heart will be very small, like just like a slit. What happens to the hemidiaphragms? Diaphragm is normally concave like this, right?
Yes.
Like these are the, so diaphragm will be more or less flat.
Okay.
Why? Because lungs are expanded to the vertical direction.
Yes.
So flat diaphragms. What happens to the intercostal spaces? The distance between intercostal spaces
will increase.
Will increase. That is what is an X-ray finding. Very simple.
Yes.
Or lungs will be more black in color compared to normal. That's how we can compare. Yes. We can also go for other investigation called a PFT, pulmonary function test. Now, what will be your finding in the pulmonary function test? Tidal volume?
Increased. Decreased.
Decreased, right? Because the lungs are already not emptying properly.
Yes.
So, yes. What is expiratory reserve volume? It also will reduce.
Yes.
Expiratory reserve volume will also reduce. Total lung capacity?
It will reduce.
Total lung capacity, total amount of air which is there in the lungs.
Yes, it will decrease.
How will it decrease? Total amount, total lung capacity is to total volume of air which is there in the lungs. Because air is trapped into the lungs, right?
Yes.
The air is trapped into the lung, total lung capacity will?
Okay, increase.
Increase. We also have one more thing, it's called a forced vital capacity. FBC. What is forced vital capacity? This is what is pathognomic of asthma.
Sir, I don't know this. Okay.
Forced vital capacity. Remember that. Because what is the problem in asthma? There is a bronchus which is constricted, right?
Yes.
Bronchi which are constricted. So air is not going out properly.
Yes.
Am I right? Air is not going out properly. So what they do, they ask the patient to inhale forcibly. And then exhale forcibly. In a normal patient, when you're asked to inhale forcibly and exhale forcibly, you are able to empty your lungs in 3 seconds normally. In that first second, removes 80% of air. Second second, 90%. Third second, 95 to 99%.
Okay.
In the normal lung. In the first second, kitna bar aa raha hai? 80%.
80.
In a normal patient. What will happen to the asthmatic patient in the forced vital capacity? First second mein itna bahar aayega, nahi aayega?
No.
No, it will not come out, right?
Yes.
Because the bronchi are constricted. So, the first second wala is also called as an FVC1. Stands for forced vital capacity in first second. This is reduced.
Okay.
That is what is pathognomic of?
Asthma.
Pathognomic of asthma. Forced vital capacity. In a very lame language, very simple language. Because this is what is a pathognomic of an asthma. Will he be able to throw all the air out in 3 seconds? Or it will require less time or more time?
It will take more time.
Take more time. More than 3 seconds. More than 3 seconds. And the treatment is what is a bronchodilator. That is what we're going to learn during this particular. So this is how initially, of course, it took a little more time because initially it may take a little more time because once the frequency matches, maybe I'll understand what you know, then things goes rather more smooth. So we are going to understand. This is what an epidemiology. Of course, we know there are so many patients who are suffering from an asthma. Not important for only for your understanding. Pathophysiology mein kya hota hai? What exactly happens in the pathophysiology?
First, the patient gets exposed to the allergen.
Right. So these are the things that predispose the patient to an asthma.
Yes.
Like for example, patient have childhood infections, allergens exposure, first exposure, indoor pollution. Somebody who is an smoker, or maybe there's an chula that is going on. Mm-hmm. Or dietary infections, pets, this can increase. We also have certain things that are going to protect against an asthma. Like large, how can large families protect against asthma? Large families protect against asthma. See, this, they always say that more is the viral infections in the family, especially the respiratory viral infection, less is an asthma.
Okay.
Because it is an asthma is an immune response to the allergens, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that means the immune system is not that mature. When the patient becomes more virally infected, patient has got the immune system matures more. And because of that, we see less asthmatic patients in India than in abroad. Abroad, we see more asthmatic patients because they have got more cleaner atmosphere. And that is what can predispose to more asthmatic. Also, more pets. Mm. Pets can also be an allergens. Also be an allergen. So this is one. Do we go to know? Now, what are the clinical features I talked about? Clinical features are episodes of wheeze, right? Chest tightness, restlessness.
Yes.
That can also be predisposed because of the cold and chest infections. Cold and chest infection. That is what can be the clinical features. Now, this is what I talked about. You know that forced vital, forced expiratory volume or forced vital capacity. It is less than, or it is reduced by 15%.
Okay.
At least reduced by 15%. That is what is a diagnosis of an asthma. This is what is a diagrammatic way of representation.
Hmm.
When you prescribe them the bronchodilator, then there is an improvement in the forced vital capacity. That is what is an okay. Management. Yes. What are the three pathologies I talked about? First pathology was? See, normally this lecture gets disconnected automatically in 40 minutes.
Okay.
Now, our every lecture lasts for almost 90 minutes. So we connect again. I'll generate another ID and then you can get connected again. Okay. Because this is what is the limit of this Zoom lecture. At one time, we can connect, take only for 40 minutes. So usually it gets, if you get disconnected, I do connect again. And now if it gets disconnected right now, I won't connect again because no, you have understood how exactly things are going. Things will be there, right?
Yes.
So they will. We initially explain the conceptual thing, then we'll go to the so that you can also understand.